إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. عباد الله، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أعاذني الله وإياكم منها. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قال ما منعك ألا تسجد إذ أمرتك قال أنا خير منه خلقتني من نار وخلقته من طين. What prevented you, O Iblis, from not prostrating as I commanded you? He said, I'm better than him. You've created him from fire, you created me from fire, and you created him from a clay. Brothers and sisters in Islam, what is why it is spread in our communities, in Muslim lands, is jealousy and envy, hasad. And we hear a lot of horror stories, what has been done, what Muslims are willing to go and commit, and how far they're willing to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you gotta wonder at times, what would it take for somebody or an individual to go around or to seek a magician or a sahir to cast a witchcraft on an individual or another Muslim? Is it because it feels that individual oppressed him or taking something a right away from him, or an issue that he has between him, or a just and straight up jealousy and envy, or hating on one another? Some are willing to go far enough until that individual is dead. And there is a lot of the ummah that died away because of that, of al-hasad. Wallahi la ilaha illallah, you will hear horror stories. And when some shiur will start reading on an individual and shoot right away, they will know this individual has got sihr on him, or has got jinni on him, a witchcraft, or whatever. And you gotta wonder, what type of a heart would do such a thing? How far is he away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to commit such an act? How is it that he's willing to see the destruction of a family, this destruction of marriage, destruction of children and offspring? And his heart is okay for that. Has he forgotten that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask him one day? Has he forgotten that he's going to be summoned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone? And he's got nothing in front of him except his deed? What type of heart would do such a thing? Brothers and sisters in Islam, a heart is that one who's willing to go that far, that is willing to go into that destruction and that type of crime and that type of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a deviant heart. A heart that does not carry deen of Islam in him. A heart that is full of darkness. A heart that is willing to hurt people just to get some type of satisfaction. There is no such thing as that heart that will say, إِذَا عَجَبَكُمْ شَيْءٍ فَقُولُوا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. And at times it's ironic when you see a brother that is willing to say some good things about an individual or about something that he liked, but he would not say, MashaAllah wa la quwwata illa billah. As if that is a little too much for him to say that. And that is just another path of going into that direction, wa la'udhu billah. Wallahi, brothers and sisters in Islam, fact is, we all know somebody that has been hurt by something like this. We all know. It goes back to the heart. أَلَا فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةٌ إِذَا صَلَحَ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. For indeed, there is a clock in a human body, regardless how big, regardless how small the body is, regardless who it is, in that heart, if it is good, then the rest of the deed is good. But if that, the rest of the body is good, but if that heart is horrible and bad or evil, then do not expect any good from him. بَدْرَانَ عَلَى قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانِ يَكْسِبُونَ. For indeed, what they used to do, what they used to commit, is taking over their hearts. With all of that, the doors of repentance is wide open. By taking responsibility and taking that leadership in one's heart, leading that heart by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and seeing the light and repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if we do not hold yourself or myself or everybody else's self hold accountable their actions and ask him, why do I do this? Why is it that I like this? Why is it that I say this? And not holding accountable myself, then النفس أمارة بسوء إلا من رحم ربي. For indeed, the nafs always seeking destruction except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mercy on. So the responsibility be upon that individual. We say, how come I don't say, mashallah, when I see something good? How come my heart is always wishing harm to people? How come is it that I get a bit of satisfaction when I see somebody doing horrible, worse than me? If I'm in school, I want everybody else to do horrible. And I want to be the only one of you, I want to be above them. Then you gotta ask yourself, why are you like that? Because your heart is not in the right place. لا يؤمن أحدكم, and this is an assurance and guarantee for every Muslim on this earth. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of us will be a true believer unless you wish for your brother or you wish for yourself. If you wish success in this life, then you're gonna have to wish it for your brother. If you wish happiness in marriage, the same thing for your brother. If you want office brings and righteous children, you're going to have to wish it for your brother. Otherwise, you need to check your email. It is an assurance and guarantee. لا يؤمن أحدكم. None of you will be a true believer unless that you wish for yourself, when you wish for your brother. But when you see in the community, some of us, it's horrible, brothers and sisters in Islam. They get satisfaction when they see others are getting hurt. They're getting in harm's way, or getting fired from a job, or not succeeding in school, or God forbid a child dies. Then there is something not right in our heart, brothers and sisters in Islam. And this is a straight up fact. Unless you take a responsibility and you start whipping your heart in shame, then you're fooling yourself. We're fooling ourselves, wa'udhu billah. عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تناقضوا ولا تحاسدوا ولا تدابروا ولا تقاطعوا وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا. This hadith was narrated by Anas رضي الله عنه that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, do not hate one another, do not hate on one another, do not envy one another, jealousy and envy, brothers and sisters in Islam, do not cut off one another. Instead, be brothers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And وَلَا يَحِلُّ لِلْمُسْلِمِ أَنْ يَهْجُرُ أَخَاهُ فَوْقَ ثَلَاثٍ. And indeed, it is not lawful for a Muslim to stay away from his brother, quarrel-wise, issues-wise, 3 days. The path of Islam is very clear, brothers and sisters in Islam. You cannot pretend, or reinvent Islam on your own fancies and whims. Unless you check your fancies and whims, before you know it, you'd be on a path of destruction and our heart may not be responding. At times you gotta wonder, why is it when you give an advice to a brother that he's not willing to listen? Because that heart is that issue. So the first ma'siyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heavens is Iblis. When he forgot, when he refused to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he decided to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the command that gave him by prostrating to Adam alayhi salam, but also the other hole that he dug for himself too, that was the kibr, arrogance. And what prevents people from listening to the haqq, to the truth, is arrogant, brother and sister, is in Islam. There is that chip in the shoulder. Unless you curb that chip, this is going to take you to paths of destruction. لا يدخل الجنة ترى من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. No one will enter Jannah if he has the atom's weight of arrogance. And that hadith is scary, brothers and sisters in Islam. It is an authentic hadith. But it speaks to our heart. It speaks to us. We have to face the mirror and say, where am I from this? Where am I from this hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why is it I walk around with a chip on my shoulder? Why is it when it comes to my relatives or to my family members, I'm so harsh on that? Or to others when it comes to tribe, oh, I'm so-and-so from this tribe, oh, I'm so-and-so from this country, I'm better than this. At times, some, they ask you, where you from? And probably most of us suffer from this. They will ask you, where you from? And then he's not interested to know where you from. He just want to put you in a shop, in a level. He wants to ask you, where you from? You tell him, I'm from this. Now he's going to put you in a level. And that heart, brother and sister, is Islam, that it is a chip on your shoulder. That's called arrogance. Muslims are equal. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once said it to everyone. An-nasi ka'affa. He did not better so and so and that said and so, except with taqwa. No one is better than another. Why is it some in this community, they walk around, they think they're better than everybody else. They think, hey, listen, I'm from so-so country. At times, the minute that you know that where you're from, they won't even leave, make you leave Salah. Because automatically he thinks he's better than you. And what does that say to that heart? If somebody is doing that, refrain from that. Go back to Allah and repent to Allah because your heart is not in the right place. No wonder when some are willing to harm people by hasad, by witchcraft, amal. Some that are willing to sell their own soul to the shayateen so that they can inflict harm on another. They're willing to completely sell their akhirah because arrogance, hate, jealousy, envy, and these are not the attribute of a believer. A believer is humble. أَزِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. A believer is humble when it comes to other believers. He's humble to the Muslims. He's not walking around pushing people away. He's not going around pretending that he's better than anybody else. If he's a true believer, then he's going to have to follow the path of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Muhammad alayhi wa sallam was humble. And he would say to people, قُولُ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. The servant of Allah, the slave of Allah, and his messenger. That is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He found pride in becoming the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So was the companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then what do we get off thinking we're better than others? Did you look into your book? Did you see your level in Jannah and you think you're better than anybody? This is dar al-amal. This is what we're supposed to be committing deeds. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Hasten to the path of your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Jannah, the width of heavens and earth. Prepare for who, brother and sister Islam? Al-Muttaqeen. Al-Muttaqeen. The pious. The humble. The one that is humble to the Muslims. Some, they're willing to treat the non-Muslims with respect. But when it comes to the Muslim, everything is reversed. If you go into a Muslim business, he is giving him the worst of treatment. But when he goes to the non-Muslims, he's respectful. And he's not going to argue about the price. He's going to pay, and he's going to give a thank you after that. But when it comes to Muslims, he sees the worst of treatment. Nas'al Allah al-afiyah. Why is it Muslims are becoming like that? When we have the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-kitab wa sunnah, and the Quran is full of stories. The ahadith are full of stories. Are we willing to disregard them and invent our own path?
subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are in the sujood, we are the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are we saying in the sujood? Are we saying, oh Allah, forgive my arrogance? Or are we saying, oh Allah, humble me? Or are we saying, oh Allah, accept me? Or is it, I'm going to forget about the whole thing, and I'm just going to go my own way? I'm going to hit those raka'at so fast, because it's a routine that I do, but it's got no connection to my deed. One of the curious things the brother told me is that we, from wherever we come from, is that we find cheating is to be smart. He says, in our community, when we cheat, that has been smart. Subhanallah. Is this a new deen, a new religion that we don't know of? You're saying la ilaha illallah and Muhammad Rasulullah. You're saying that you're a Muslim. Then why do you come up? How dare you come up with something like that? How dare you think this is the way to go? Did you see Muhammad alayhi salam cheat? Did you see the companion of Muhammad alayhi salam cheat? No, Allah, they did not cheat. They would go as far as it takes them to be truthful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and honest. The deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot invent Islam. You cannot reinvent it by so-called social media or whatever that people are telling you to do, or shuyukh as-salatin or whatsoever. No way. Islam is Islam. Islam is going to stay Islam until the day of judgment. And we're going to come and go. And others are going to come. And they're going to take over. And they're going to have that same fitna. A dunya. Them trees, they're going to probably still around when we are all dead and gone. And the only thing that is going to keep us the 4x4, the grave, alone, away from your tribe, the one that you're going around, pride, thinking I'm so on this, I'm so on that. They're not going to be there with you. That is the reality. Your family, think again. They're not going to be there with you. The only thing you got to see is what? Your deed. Your deed, your righteous deed. And your hope, your righteousness will be there for you. And that is the fact, and that is the truth. And none of us is going to live long. Ummati ma bayna 60 wa 70. This ummah, between 60 and 70. And the one that is going to surpass that are very few. How old are you? Do the math. That is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam. لا يجتمعان لا يجتمعان في قلب عبد الإيمان والحسد. And this is an assurance, brothers and sisters in Islam. There is no way. There will never be Iman and envy and hasad together in one's heart. It cannot be. It's impossible. If you claim Iman, hasad cannot be in your heart. These are all guarantees. So if you have a bit of hasad, a bit of envy in your heart, get cracking. And start whooping off how you are in shape. Because the only thing that you have to see forward is your deed. أقول ما تسمعوا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفرونه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الملك الحق المبين وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله البشير النذير وسراج المنير والنبي الأمين صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى أهله وأصحابه أجمعين. واعلم أن ما أصابك ما كان ليخطئك. And this comes that having a good assumption of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know for sure that whatever harmed you, whatever attacked you, whatever striked you, it was not meant to miss you. And that itself is iman bil qadar. That you are accepting whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed upon you. And have a good assumption. حسن الظن بالله سبحانه وتعالى. Have a good assumption that inshallah عز وجل Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would make something good for you. Wallahi الذي لا إله إلا هو. You can go out there and practice it. If you have a good assumption of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will see it in your day. If you get fired from a job, don't be cursing around. Don't be saying, why me? Why isn't that always me? You always hear this. I'm always facing hardship, brother. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have you visited the hospitals? Have you seen the brothers that are quadriplegic? Have you seen the brothers that can't even take one step? Having good assumption of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from the Iman, brothers and sisters, is Islam. And that is the reflection, the true reflection of your Iman. But if you every time you get harmed by something, or you get struck by something, you get stuck, you know, feeling down, depressed, locking yourself up in the room, you don't want to talk to the brothers, you're not answering the phone because you've been hit with something, then know for sure that your heart needs some work. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَنْ يَتْرَكُوا أَنْ يَقُولُوا أَمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يَفْتَنُونَ. Have people thought they believe to be left? That they claim to be to say that we believe. We believe and not be tested. This is dunya. This is the test. What, do you think Jannah's cheap? Do you think Jannah's easy? You're just gonna go to it, that's it? You're gonna be tested with everything that you love and you care about. What is the sense of you getting tested with something that you don't care about? What is the sense of it? But you're gonna be tested with something that you care about. You're gonna be tested with your family, you're gonna be tested with your health, you're gonna be tested with everything that is essentially important to you. In essence, it becomes a reflection of your heart, a reflection of your iman. What are you standing on this? Last but not least, brothers and sisters, Islam wa asri inna l-insan al-fi khusri illa ladhina aamanu wa amilu s-salihati wa tawasu bil-haqti wa tawasu bil-sabr. But surely live time, surely the human being is in a state of loss, except who advocate righteousness and forbid evil, exhort one another to accept the path and accept the truth and exhort one another to be steadfast. وصلى عباد الله على رسول الهدى وخير الورى فقد امركم بذلك المولى جل وعلا حيث قال ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على رسولك المجتبى ونبيك المصطفى افضل الخلق وخير الورى سيدنا محمد وعلى اهله واصحابه اهل السر ووفى اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات ربنا إنك غريب مجيب الدعوات وغافر الذنب والخطايا ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء يا رب العالمين اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء يا رب العالمين اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المسلمين المستضعفين في سبيلك في كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم كن لهم عونا ومعينا اللهم كن لهم عونا ومعينا اللهم كن لهم عونا ومعينا يا رب العالمين اللهم عليك بمن ظلمهم اللهم عليك بمن قتلهم اللهم عليك بمن شردهم اللهم عليك بمن عاوى وعاون على تشريدهم يا رب العالمين اللهم احصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تقاتل منهم احدا ابدا اللهم انهم لا يعجزونك واقم الصلاه